Keep this history in mind as we work through our exploratory analysis. The first thing you might consider doing is plotting key variables against each other using the ggpairs function. This function plots each variable against each other variable pairwise. You may want to sample first, otherwise the function will take a long time to render the plots. Also, if your dataset has more than about 10 columns, there will be too many plotting windows, so subset on your columns first if that's the case. The first thing we want to do is make sure you have these packages installed. We'll be using ggally for this particular plot. We use scales for a variety of things, mmisc to summarize the regression, lattice for a few other things, mass for various functions, char to recode variables, reshape to reshape and wrangle your data, plier to create interesting summaries and transformations of your data. We'll go ahead and load these packages and then set the seed for randomization purposes and sample 10,000 rows from the Diamonds dataset. What's happening is that ggpairs is plotting each variable against the other in a pretty smart way. In the lower triangle of the plot matrix, it uses grouped histograms for qualitative-qualitative pairs and scatter plots for quantitative-quantitative pairs. In the upper triangle, it plots grouped histograms for qualitative-qualitative pairs, this time using the x instead of the y variable as the grouping factor, box plots for qualitative-quantitative pairs, and it provides the correlation for quantitative-quantitative pairs. Remember that our goal is to understand the price of diamonds, so let's focus on that. The price variable is here, so let's look at the relationships that correspond to price. What are some things you notice? There's no right or wrong answer here, but think deeply about the plots and the associations you see. Write a few sentences about what stands out to you.